Well, welcome back. A new restaurant catering to vegetarians and vegans and everyone that loves good food is now open. In fact, it opened just a couple of weeks ago. It is gorgeous in Calhoun Square. As you can see there, it is called Fig and Farro's. It's a plant-based menu. It has a mission to help diners reduce their carbon footprint. What a gorgeous spot. And we're so excited that you came to Care 11 News Saturday. We have co-founder Tom Cambrine here, and we have chef Robbie Sims. How you guys doing?
Not so bad. How about you?
Ready so you are in that beautiful space that used to be Filio.
That's
so
right.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And how many weeks?
Just over 2 weeks. Just opened on the 24th of January.
Oh my goodness. That's a big deal.
Yes. Thank you.
How's it going?
It's going great. Yes. We've been starting to serve our vegetarian food with a mission to fight climate change. And the way to fight climate change, because studies are showing that meat production contributes to more greenhouse emission than most automobile, car, and transportation in the world. So our way of fighting climate change is to teach everyone how to eat a delicious vegetarian diet.
Well, congratulations on that. And we have video of your beautiful restaurant. So we'll go back to that video and show you how beautiful it is. And again, in that spot, so do you make reservations? Is it open breakfast, lunch, and dinner? When do you open?
We open every day for lunch and dinner. And then on weekend, we have brunch as well.
Oh, that's fantastic. Look how pretty that is. Lots of tables there where folks can sit together. You know, what a great spot to be in Uptown, because you've got that clientele right there that obviously would love to come in and check it out. And what are we making this morning? Because I've never heard this before. What's it called?
Today we are making a Middle Eastern dish called shakshuka.
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 It's not really regionally specific, as most people claim to have invented it themselves, but it's extraordinarily simple. Anybody can make it, but it's extremely delicious and flavorful.
Fantastic. So I see a bunch of peppers and tomatoes and garlic over there, some cilantro.
Basic assortment of fresh veggies. And want me to get started?
Yeah, go.
All right, so just throw some oil in the pan. Get your veggies going. Onions and garlic first.
Oh, that looks good. Lots of red onion. I love red onion.
Oh, no, me too. And plenty of garlic, because I'm crazy like that. And I don't mind how my breath smells.
That is a lot. That is a Bobby Jensen portion of garlic right there. Right, Bobby?
Come
oh, my
down.
Goodness. I love it.
All right.
It.
And then you add tomatoes to the mix. Lots of red peppers. And basically, you're just going to have this stewing for anywhere between 20 minutes to an hour or more, if you like.
And then as we get into the season, of course, you'll use seasonal vegetables. And these days, there are indoor farms, even in the Midwest. Of course, tomatoes come from Bushel Boy in the southern part of the state. So that's a big important thing to you as well. The distance, right?
Yes, it is the distance and also the quality of the ingredients. Most of our produce is organic. Part of it is because of health reasons, but the main reason is because organic production is also a contributor to fighting climate change.
That's fantastic. So what do we do now, sir?
Now we just sit and wait. We had some seasonings. I put cayenne, salt, and pepper in there.
Wow, and so it boils down for a long time. Then you end up with something.
It all boils down.
Look how pretty this is.
You end up with this delicious stew,
oh,
and you crack a few eggs over in there and let those cook inside of the stew on their own. And then the finished product is usually done in about 10, 15 minutes.
Oh, so how long did it take to get from this to this before the eggs went on?
Usually in the restaurant, we stew everything for about an hour to hour and a half, depending.
So if you're at home, count on that, right?
It doesn't even take that long.
Oh, not that long.
We're doing large batch stuff, so
we try to
do it in mass.
And I really noticed that the pan matters. You need a good, heavy, sturdy pan so that it can actually really get that done. And then the eggs on top.
Eggs on top.
Oh my goodness!
Put a lid on it. Let those things steam and cook, and you'll know when they're done.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you
for cooking.
Thanks
and
so much.
Congratulations
you
to you
much.
As well. Fig and Farro. Everybody can find it at Calhoun Square in Uptown. And we have a link to this gorgeous recipe. You can try it at home this weekend. And we will be right back.